Day 51 was an absolute cracker. Alan, Levina, Aria and I all woke up early and jump on so we could get away and enjoy what was going to be a 6 to 7 hour ride through to Phuket, heading south, then west across the Thai Peninsula to the west coast where Phuket is located. We were staying in a nice hotel, the Novotel, recommended by Derek from CM Wheels. Good on you, Derek. It was a great location. Shame we couldn't spend longer. We had to get going. We did have beautiful weather to ride in, although it did get hot. It was mostly blacktop the whole way, although, as usual, where there was a road off to the side that looked a little bit less travelled, we were sure to take it up. On occasions, we even got onto some gravel. The driver that was following Alan and I, carrying Levina and Aria, did a great job to keep up with the bikes. We saw lots of villages and children and different things along the way. The scenery, the rolling mountains, were all absolutely splendid. We stopped on numerous occasions just to take it all in. The quality of the roads in Thailand continues to impress me and enables us to carry very high speeds when necessary. The traffic eased off when we hit the provincial road, an east-west road, and on that road we were able to really immerse ourselves in the culture of this area, which is particularly Islamic, as we move further south in Thailand. The architecture, the food, the style of clothing all reflected that cultural change as we move through. By far and away, the highlight of today was an incredible stop. It was a stop that we made just after a town called Phuket, which was on the about halfway between Champon and Phuket. I'd seen many signs indicating waterfalls off to the left and right pretty much the whole way today, and in every instance I just ignored it. But for some reason, one sign caught my eye and I decided that we would take the 5 kilometer detour off the main road to see what this waterfall was all about. The road came to a dead end. And at the dead end was parked a huge Mercedes-Benz tractor, van, truck. I've never seen anything like it. It was decorated with graphics to show that this particular truck/tractor was on an around the world adventure. As soon as I saw that, I became intrigued. On the other side of the tractor, facing the waterfall and national park ahead, was Matthew and his friend from Poland. Matthew's from Germany and he's spending the last year traveling around the world. We got talking, and as one adventurer to another adventurer, shared many stories of our travels. Wonderful to meet him, thoroughly enjoyed it. Eventually we made our way through and walked 200 meters to a waterfall. The images here can show you exactly what it was like. I don't know how to describe it other than to say it was paradise, my dream coming true. After refreshing in the waterfall, it was back into the riding gear and off for the final couple of hundred kilometers through to Phuket, where we would be greeted by Alan's family eagerly awaiting our arrival. This was another great day on the Wheel2Wheel expedition. I continue to enjoy so much having Alan ride with me. He's a terrific traveling companion. And of course, it remains special to have Aria and Levina along for the journey as well, taking in all of these unique experiences that would be difficult to ever replicate. Great day for Wheel2Wheel. I look forward to many more like this. Truly epic.
From the very first time I started thinking about this expedition, I had this crazy idea in my head that I'd be able to pull off the road, take off my riding suit, and dive into some random waterfall that would be as picturesque as this. Well, it took until day 51 to find it that we've finally done it. Alan and I, Levina and Aria, we've all dived in here, about 5 km off the main road that we're taking from Champon to Phuket, and here we are. It's just brilliant. I'm standing here in the nude, in nature, loving it.
So coming to join Morgan on the Wheel2Wheel expedition, I was really looking forward to seeing our work with the charity and being part of that, but I was also really looking forward to the riding. And today has been one of those great riding days. We've spent 2 hours riding a sensational, winding, scenic, beautiful road through Thailand, heading south towards Phuket, and we finished here in the most stunning oasis. This waterfall, beautiful river, lost in the Thai jungle somewhere.